Well, it was Game of Thrones that said winter is coming, but whew, I can tell you nothing could have prepared us for the cold snap that's hit our state this week. It has been very, very frosty trackside, but on track, things have really been heating up. So let's take a look at it. Let's get into it for another edition of The Sprint Lane. And what a week it's been. In fact, what a month. 28 qualifying heats, 4 regional finals culminating in the ultimate decider, the state final of the TAB Regional Championships at Menangle on Saturday night.
I like me better, eases across carts, starts to come on, but it's Sended, 100 metres left to go, still in front, trying hard, Kiyang Cruiser lead, I like me better, but Sended is a state champion.
A superb driving and training performance from Brad Hewitt there on Sended, and check out these great photos, that's one of the owners of Sended, Cody Medway, revelling in the moment, and a great advertisement for the joy that comes with winning a Group 1 race. Now, fellow owner Canberra Raiders captain Jared Croker was watching at home from the couch. Now, even though the Raiders were playing at the same time and doing it pretty tough against the Roosters, I can tell you Jared was changing channel at just the right moment and giving out just as many high fives from the lounge room as Cody was in those photos. Well done to all the connections of Sendit, and well done to Brad's cousin Gemma Hewitt as well. She just missed a second Group 1 in as many weeks with Kiyang Cruiser, but in the race beforehand, they teamed up to win the consolation final with Cash Us Back.
Blackhawk Joe's descending upon them. Cash Us Back goes to the lead. Inch by inch, Blackhawk Joe cuts back the margin. Cash Us Back lifts. Cash Us Back won the consolation, I reckon.
Cash is an incredible story. He battled illness as a yearling and Gemma was told he wouldn't live. And then when he pulled through, she was told he'd never race. Well, they proved everyone wrong. And in May alone, Kiyang Cruiser and Cash Us Back raked in more than 100 grand in prize money between them. Fantastic story. Now, I was at Menangle for trials on Tuesday. Great to see King of Swing, Bright Energy and Better Enforce being put through their paces. The racing moved to Armidale on Sunday and it was the Dale March trained Clintel Doo producing an absolute space job in the feature Armidale Cup.
Making an absolute mess of them in the straight, Clintel Doo in the cup. It's well clear over Master Catch, who works to second, followed by Dad Is It and also I'm Compliant, but a big win in the cup to Clintel Doo. Goes home to win well.
Now, Peak Hills Carnival of Cups meet is on Sunday. A reminder, that's been hosted by the Dubbo Club this year. That leaves just Cowra in a few weeks' time. And then, of course, Bankstown. The time-honoured Truer Memorial has been run on the Queen's Birthday public holiday Monday. That should be a great day on track out there. Now, off track, well, track side, we hosted the Breeders and Owners Forum at Menangle on Saturday. It was fantastic to have such a strong turnout of people from all over New South Wales. It was a chance to canvass ideas and opinions and hear from a broad range of industry participants on the key issues. Now, this was all about building and continually striving to do things better. And I've got no doubt a lot was achieved at that forum. A reminder to attendees, you've got until Monday afternoon to get those feedback forms back to us. While we're talking about the breeding industry, a huge congratulations to Mark Cruato on being announced as the recipient of the prestigious Don Clough Award by the New South Wales Harness Breeders Association. And of course, while we're throwing around the applause, we must congratulate Brian Portelli and Blake Fitzpatrick, who headed south last weekend for the APG Group 1 final for colts and geldings.
Act Now's trying hard. Captain Crusader's late on the scene with Better Isolate from downtown, but it's still Tasty Delight. He's going to lead all the way and win the Group 1 APG for the 3-year-old colts and geldings.
A dominant win that from Tasty Delight. Well done, gents. That was a performance to remember. I hope you've had a great week. I hope next week is even better. Please stay safe, be kind to each other, and don't forget to follow all the social distancing protocols. Thanks for tuning in. I'll catch you next week on The Sprint Lane.